Okay, my name's Victoria and this is my story. I wanted to do this video because I wanted to tell everybody about Thrive and what it's done for me. But I've written it down so I can read it because I didn't want to miss anything out, because people need to hear everything. So I hope it helps. I'm 41 and have experienced emetophobia from the age of 3. Living in fear every day, terrified when I was at school that somebody in the class would be sick, panicking when somebody coughed, shuffled or moved in an unusual way, terrified of school trips and assemblies just in case, scared to eat away from home and scared to eat at home. As I grew up, the fear continued. To be perfectly honest, I didn't realise that there was anything wrong with me. I thought everybody was like this, but it slowly dawned on me that I was different and that other people actually enjoyed their life. But I was trapped by then and couldn't see a way out of the cage I had created for myself. Holidays were a source of anxiety rather than enjoyment. Not being able to relax, fearing everything as it was different. I wasn't in my safe situation, well, as safe as I could be in my safe situation. My safe situation was just less anxiety producing and more predictable, but didn't feel completely safe. I was still scared. Pubs and clubs where my friends wanted to be drinking were pure terror. Emetophobia restricted my social life, my education, my relationships. It eliminated any enjoyment in my life as I lived in constant fear, experiencing daily multiple panic attacks. I was exhausted as I was on alert all the time, waiting for something to happen, waiting to run and escape. After a breakdown in my late 30s and becoming agoraphobic, on a day of desperation, I googled effective treatment for emetophobia. I felt that this was a futile act as I had received CBT, which made me worse, and EMDR over previous years with a little improvement. But the improvement was mainly down to me facing my fears and making them more normal. I still lived in terror. The Google search came up with Thrive. It looked good, but I believed it was just another one of those things that I'd try and get excited about, but then realise that it wouldn't work. The idea that I would be free of emetophobia in 6 weeks was just ridiculous. I knew it wouldn't work, but I was so desperate and I didn't know where else to turn that I gave it a go. I battled against the book, finding and picking on any reason why Rob was wrong and why it wasn't going to work. But the book made sense. Thrive made sense. I couldn't ignore that. So I suspended belief and followed the exercises. I committed to doing them well as I possibly could, and was amazed that they worked. I started to improve. In 2 weeks, I was no longer agoraphobic. In 4 weeks, emetophobia had significantly improved because I knew that I could handle anything that happened. I was seeing a glimpse of happiness and starting to see light at the end of the tunnel. A new world started to open up before me. Now I see myself as an ex-emetophobic. Yes, I still have challenges, but I win. I can cope, and I never cease to be amazed when I don't react to old triggers. And if you are going to ask, yes, I still have to work at Thrive, but why wouldn't I? It's given me my life back. I have now returned to work as an artist and am training to be a Thrive consultant because I just think it is so wonderful. Thrive works even if you think it won't. And I've written a piece which I'd like to read to you about what I can now do because of Thrive. It's called Because of Thrive. Because of Thrive, I no longer fear being sick every moment of my life. Because of Thrive, I can eat that food that has been sitting in the fridge, was once dodgy in my mind, but acceptable to others. Because of Thrive, I can now look after my son if he is ill. Without worry, I can take my son for vaccines at the doctor's, sitting in the waiting room, not worrying about the germs in the air, or on the floor, or on the seats, or on the door. I can brush it off when someone coughs or opens a sweet wrapper or spills some water. I no longer react. I can get on a train and travel with other people without worrying about breathing the air and touching things that might be contaminated or people that might do odd things. I can and have been to a performance where for the duration of the event, the artist consumes 24 donuts and 4 cans of spray cream. You can imagine what that does to somebody. And before, I wouldn't have even considered going to that performance. Yet, I could stand there and watch. Bizarre, I know, and I stood at a distance. And it was disgusting to watch, but it would be disgusting to watch for anybody. That was the whole point of the performance, to create disgust in the audience. But there was no adverse reaction for me. No pounding heart. No panic. No shakiness. No need to run. No need to get away. I stood there with curiosity, the same as everybody else, just watching the performance and what might happen. I was so excited because there was just no reaction. It was just, there was just nothing there. Because that's because I know that whatever happens, I can cope. Because of Thrive, I no longer worry about the norovirus. I can go into public places during winter, which I couldn't before. From October to February was a danger zone for me. It's now not. I can go into my son's school without worrying. I no longer notice all the headlines on the newspaper about closed accident and emergency units and hospital wards due to the virus. I no longer react if I hear people talking about it. I no longer worry unduly and take normal precautions. I am freed from its chains that I now know that I created. Because of Thrive, I no longer have agoraphobia. 2 weeks it took me, just 2 weeks. Imagine that. Instead of 4 walls, I have earth and sky. I now have a cool breeze on my face. When I go outside, instead of the stale air in the house. Instead of limited behaviour, I have unlimited possibilities and happiness. And because of Thrive, I can live.